Heritable thoracic aortic disease include both syndromic and non-syndromic forms, with as a common denominator thoracic aortic aneurysms and dissections. These often do not show any visible signs until fatal events occur. Among the syndromic forms of HTAD, Marfan syndrome is the best known and longest studied. Marfan syndrome is clinically characterized by skeletal features, typical skeletal features, and by lens luxation along with the thoracic aortic disease. It is caused by mutations in the FBN1 gene in over 90% of cases, but mutations in other genes, such as the TGF-beta receptor 2 gene, have also been identified in patients fulfilling the criteria. Other syndromes include the Lewis Dietz syndrome, which is characterized by a bifid uvula and hypertillerism with important arterial tortuosity. Lewis Dietz syndrome is caused by genes encoding components of the TGF-beta pathway. Smooth muscle cell dysfunction syndrome is another rare and recently identified syndromic entity caused by a specific mutation in the ACTA2 gene at the position R179. Patients are born with either patent ductus arteriosus or an open pulmonary window, and also show congenital bilateral mitriasis of the eyes and typical cerebral vessel abnormalities called Moya-Moya-like features. By definition, non-syndromic HTAD comprises entities without any extra aortic features. Genes involved in non-syndromic HTAD are found in all genes that are also identified in the syndromic forms, along with a number of other genes such as the PRKG1 and MYLK gene. The genes in HTAD can be grouped into those genes involved in smooth muscle cell contraction, adhesion to the extracellular matrix, or the TGF-beta pathway. Given the important clinical overlap between the syndromes and that multiple genes are involved in the non-syndromic forms of HTAD, it is wise to go for panel testing when embarking on genetic analysis. Deciding on what genes should be involved in these panels can be quite difficult. To guide the selection of genes that should be involved in these panels, a recent publication showing a list of curated genes with a proven gene-disease association will show you a list of category A genes that should be involved in these panels, along with a list of more recently identified genes that should at least be involved in research laboratories. Mutation detection rate is high for syndromic forms, often over 90%, and is much lower for the non-syndromic forms, often below 20%. Identification of an underlying gene in HTAD is important because it will confirm the clinical diagnosis in many patients and families. It is also important for reasons of precision medicine, where the management can be defined according to the underlying gene. You will, for example, go for more extended vascular imaging in patients with gene mutations in the TGF-beta pathway. It is also very important, of course, to pursue cascade screening in families with an identified mutation. And finally, it is important for young people with a child wish, where you can suggest prenatal or pre-implantation diagnostics.